gentlemen, the waiting's over. This is the moment we've all been waiting for. As the Professional Darts Corporation proudly present the final of the Ladbrokes Sydney Darts Masters, coming to you from the incredible city of Sydney. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to meet the finalists. Firstly, would you please welcome from Stoke-on-Trent, England, the reigning and defending Sydney Darts Master and the record-breaking, history-making, 16 times the champion of the world, it's Phil the Power of six World Series events, the reigning world number one and the former champion of the world, Mighty Michael
little smile when he greeted Phil Taylor there from Michael Van Gerwen, who quickly disappeared. It's business time. Let's get back to Rod and Stu.
This is business. This really is for both Phil Taylor and Michael Van Gerwen. A real darting rivalry, a real sporting rivalry. And we bring it to you from the stage here at the Star in Sydney. Phil Taylor, 5 out of 5 in World Series events in Australia. And he has been very, very good in Sydney in 2016. Michael Van Gerwen, the defending World Series champion, looking for his first tournament win in Australia. And Van Gerwen loves mixing it with the best, loves proving a point. He reckons he's got an edge in darting terms and a psychological edge over Phil Taylor. First to 11 to win the Sydney Darts Masters. And Phil Taylor looking for a rare success against Van Gerwen.
Do you know what, Stu? I think for Phil Taylor's career, he's had a brilliant career over a lot of years. But for the future of Phil Taylor, a win here against Michael Van Gerwen will set up perhaps 3, 4, 5 more years of him winning. But if he happens to get beaten up here, then it's going to dent his confidence again, which we know has been dented over the last 2 years on many occasions.
Well, in darting terms, Taylor demolished Michael Van Gerwen at the World Match Play Final last month, 18-10, thrashed by Van Gerwen in the Premier League final in front of over 12,000 at the O2 in London back in May. And Michael Van Gerwen started the semi-final with a 180. And he's done it again here. Van Gerwen, darting superstar, Phil Taylor, darting legend, first to 11 to win in Sydney.
Oh, that looks absolutely perfect. And he did it exactly in the semi-final. Fourth dart was absolutely plumbing the treble. The fifth dart missed. But we'd love to see a nine dart leg, but Van Gogh, all he's interested in, winning leg after leg.
100. Yeah. Phil Taylor has won three World Series titles in Sydney.
105.
He's won two in Perth, and Michael Van Gerwen has never won in the World Series in Australia. Is that all about to change? Van Gerwen has left 76 after nine in the opening leg of the final.
83. Of your boys, 76.
Well, he gets at least six from here. May only need two. Two it is. That's a beautiful 11 dart first leg from Van Gerwen. He has set his stall out straight away. Let's do. I know it. Infancy of this game, but it's so mega that Taylor holds onto his throw, because with Van Gerwen having the throw first in the match, and he comes back 3-0 all of a sudden.
Spot on, Rod. Massive, massive leg. Taylor knows it, Van Gerwen knows it.
80.
Well, only 80 scored. Possibly should have switched, and I think Michael Van Gerwen is wishing he had that final dart again. But Taylor here, on his throw,
85.
Finally hits a big treble after his sixth dart, but what a chance here for Van Gerwen with a big visit. Well, that is a crucial visit for Michael Van Gerwen. Taylor's first World Series final since Sydney last year. Incredible to think that since then, as Taylor finds the range and rhythm with a 180, hasn't reached a final in the last five in the World Series until tonight here in Australia.
Well, who can go out in six darts from here? Taylor's going to get the first chance.
97.
Well, he may get one dart. Well, he will get one dart on a double when he returns. Maybe two if he can hit the treble 20.
58.
Well, Fury
require 80.
The 180 changed it. Van Gerwen was in charge of the leg, but the 180 has given Taylor the dart. You can have one dart at tops here. It's a whole throw.
40.
Well, against Chisholm in the early part of the match, he was missing doubles all over the place. He's not going to get away with it against Michael Van Gerwen. Now he needs to find the treble to have his third dart at the ball. He's got let off there a little bit, Phil Taylor.
65. Phil, you're in more 40.
So to level up the final, the defending Sydney champion. Good dart, important dart, one all.
Yeah,
Phil Taylor, outstanding against Gary Anderson. You're going to need something like that performance, I reckon, to get close to Michael Van Gerwen. Michael Van Gerwen averaging 107 in the semi-final against Peter Wright.
Yes, and he's just under the 107 average at the moment. Phil Taylor down on 91. There we have it.
84.
That is only in the third leg. Phil Taylor's not going to worry about averages tonight. All he's going to worry about is getting in front and holding on to his throw. However, that's far easier said than done.
Yeah, but to lose so heavily 60. In two massive major finals, 61. Such as the Premier League and the World Match Play, to Michael Van Gerwen, hurt Taylor, immeasurably hurt Phil Taylor.
Well, these are little chances that Phil Taylor's going to have to jump on. I know he's out at 257, but a 140 gives him that outside chance Oh, the ton does appreciate it, but not as good as 114. So now 416s is leaving the double top. That's why I said, you know, Taylor needed a 140 because he could have come back with the 114, and all of a sudden it's turned the game in his favour. Still could.
Well, this would be something special. Van Gerwen's still got to finish it off. Magnificent on the doubles in the semi-final, 11 out of 13 against Peter Wright. Under pressure from Taylor, dealt with it beautifully, three legs all went on throw. Van Gerwen with the average of 100 and with the advantage 2-1. We haven't seen that from Phil Taylor at any stage during this World Series event in Taylor, in Sydney. Taylor celebrating a 180.
93.
Well, that's what he's got to do. He's got to fire himself up, get the adrenaline running nice and rich. Helps your concentration, helps your eyesight.
59.
Well, since he's beaten Van Gerwen twice, Taylor, in World Series finals in Australia, in Sydney, the first Sydney Darts Masters in 2013 at Luna Park, walloped him 10-3. It was close in Perth a year later, 11-9 in the Perth final. But since that final in Perth 2 years ago, Rob, he has only two wins to his name in 15 matches against Michael Van Gerwen.
140.
No one. 28. Has come close to a successful record like that against Taylor in the last 30 years.
88.
He's left to finish Van Gerwen on 134.
Yes, this would hurt. It isn't going to happen, so Taylor's going to come back to level it up. And a nice little 13 dart leg. If he leaves 40 after 12 darts on his throw, he will not lose too many legs. Just a solid leg, wasn't it, on his throw?
It's bubbling up nicely.
140.
Well, Van Gerwen, 105, but Taylor's game is improving. Up to around 97 average. Four legs, four holes of throw. It's intriguing.
100.
Looks like being close. Taylor focused, determined.
96.
Well, he won't like the lie, he will switch Van Gerwen. Goes
54.
Back up. Yeah, not a great visit from the world number one. So Taylor here will sniff an opportunity.
Well, he can't leave a finish. So Van Gerwen's going to get six darts from here. However, it is easier for Taylor from 165. So Van Gerwen needs two trebles. One may not be enough. And now, again, a chance for Phil Taylor. Needs to set this up. Needs to put the pressure on Van Gerwen and ask him the question in the early part of this game. He's hit the all-important one treble now. Van Gerwen under pressure on this 106. Now needs the treble 18. Oh, and he's missed it. Taylor is going to have his first chance to break the throw of Van Gerwen. What an important 72 this is for the power.
Huge moment in this Sydney final. He's going to have one dart to break Van Gerwen.
40.
Michael, you
require 52.
Tots of Van Gerwen. Great guide.
32.
Oh, two misses.
What
32. A big leg this is. After Taylor missed double 16, you felt sure Van Gerwen would take the leg on tops. Well, that's a great, great guide for Taylor. There we have it. Use the barrel. Van Gerwen misses. Taylor makes him pay. first real blow of this final. Strike one, Phil Taylor. He breaks the lead 3-2.
Now's the time to throw a 12 dart leg on your throw. Just take Van Gogh right out of the equation. Get a little bit of daylight. Just put a little bit of pressure. And pressure will be seen in low darts from Van Gogh. If they consistently go under the treble, then that is a sign. At the moment,
Taylor is playing better than Michael Van Gerwen.
60.
Michael Van Gerwen has much to be concerned about, Rob.
At the moment, yes. Well, Taylor's got to come down.
97.
Well, he's going to get six darts, and he's miscounted there, although Van Gerwen cannot leave a checkout, so the 168 is absolutely irrelevant, because he would not have gone the bullseye route if he had left a checkout. All he needs to do is set it up, and I think he's going to do that quite comfortably.
140.
Not the nicest of routes to leave, though, Stu, the double 14. If he splits that and goes after chase down the 16, sevens, however, then Van Gerwen's not put any pressure on, so...
A couple of poor legs from Van Gerwen, Rob.
Yes, certainly is. It's quite a comfortable double 14 now for Taylor.
There's
three legs on the spin to Phil Taylor. And we now have a huge leg, will surely come down, have to come down. Great 177, a leg that Van Gerwen simply has to win for me, heading into the first break in this final.
Well, stage one of the game has got to be ticked for Phil Taylor. He's got the little bit of daylight that he needed to get, and now he's just got to hold on. We know Van Gerwen's going to have a run of level 12s, three, four of them, sooner or later, but it could be irrelevant if Taylor can make sure he holds on to his throw.
Well, really intriguing final. 97, 98, the average for both. That will improve.
98.
Van Gerwen has a finish. Taylor could put real pressure on. A 140, he's banged back in this leg.
100.
And lucky with the last one.
130.
I reiterate, Van Gerwen has to win this leg, I feel.
90, will we record 160?
He's left tops. Oh, that's perfect. Well, I can't afford to miss here, Van Gerwen. Taylor with the advantage in the Sydney final. Pressure. Oh, how important may that prove to me? Taylor sat on double 12 for a double break of throw and total control. But Van Gerwen snaps the losing run of three straight legs. What a final this is turning out to be. Taylor with the advantage in Sydney by four legs to three. The final of the 2016 Sydney Darts Masters. It's advantage Phil Taylor with one break of throw. And Van Gerwen has been averaging around 105 during the tournament so far. His final average at the moment around 95. Needs to pick up the pace, Michael Van Gerwen. Phil Taylor is chipping away. One break of throw in the fifth leg, and Taylor with the advantage. First to 11. Taylor chasing a fourth Sydney title. Sixth in all in Australia in the World Series. Van Gerwen looking to win down under for the first time.
Well, with Van Gerwen's average down at that 90, well, just under 96. Taylor puts in his third maximum. It is giving Phil Taylor a massive edge. And perhaps the break has done him the world of good, because he's come out with a 180, although he did start the match with a 180.
Astonishing.
Oh, there's number four. Oh, one again. The fifth dart has been missed.
137.
Taylor looks in the mood, doesn't he? You get the feeling that he's sick of losing to Michael Van Gerwen.
96.
Van Gerwen is going to have to, I think, produce his A game here.
What a leg of darts to come out from the break. And you need to hold on to your throw. 44 after 9. If he closes off, doesn't get much better, Stu. And he had to do this. He had to keep the pressure on Van Gerwen.
Only just got the single. 12. But bang in. A double 16. No trouble. 11 down leg. 5-3. Taylor.
134.
Key is Taylor on his own throw. Van Gerwen hasn't had a dart to break Phil Taylor.
177.
Phil Taylor, since the break, has picked it up, hasn't he?
96.
180, 140. The last leg starts this one with a 177.
And Stu, the first dart of Michael Van Gerwen's, is starting to drop lower, that treble. He's having to switch for the 19s all the time.
Well, real pressure on the Van Gerwen throw again here. Can the world number one respond?
101.
Taylor looking to go two breaks clear of his big, big rival. Taylor with an 11 dart leg straight out of the break.
99.
He's got a possibility of another one here. Van Gerwen, though, looking at a 170. 170 on the ball!
145.
What a blow this would be for Mighty Mike. Phil Taylor's got to look at those 20s. He won't go for that bullseye with the first dart. It'd be at the treble 20. It's the old-fashioned route, but it's the solid route. Now double 15 for another break and a 6-3 lead. Oh, that was a nervy dart from Taylor. Oh, 16. What a chance!
Hardly required, 25.
Well, what a big leg that could prove to be. Phil Taylor with two darts for 6-3. And Michael Van Gerwen rescues the situation. 5-4. But so far, you know, Van Gerwen hasn't really come close to challenging Phil Taylor's throw. He's trying now, all right. Well, I think Van Gerwen knows what a big turning point that ninth leg could prove to be. 100! 180s in Sydney this year.
58.
Well, Van Gerwen knows he's got to start getting back into this game and get in front, because the closer you get to the finishing line, the more confident Phil Taylor will get,
59.
And the more pressure will come on this young man.
A little inconsistent on the scoring, and a shake of the head tells you that from Van Gerwen. 180 followed by 59.
You can't afford to do it, Stu. We call it cutting the 180 in half. And it just opens the door for your opponent, whoever it is, just to fill the bed up. Wow.
Well,
60. Six darts.
They were three really well-thrown darts for just 60. Well, the 180 at the start of the leg gave Michael Van Gerwen the advantage. 40. Phil Taylor has clawed it back. He may look at the ball here. Oh, 170! Fantastic to leave 32 to level up this match. But Taylor, one treble with the first two darts. We'll give him a dart at the double.
And they were a long way off, Stu. A little bit of pressure there 60. From Taylor. So now Van Gogh to get this break of throw back. Three clear darts at 32. Oh, one dart left. Oh, and it's in the corner, the very bottom corner of the double 16. And that's the leg back.
What a dart that was. What a blow that may prove to be. What a final this is turning into. The 170 was a fabulous shot, wasn't it? You thought Taylor had the advantage in the leg all of a sudden. But the 170 put the pressure on Taylor for the 103 finish.
Well, we talk about it all the time, don't we? Set the shot up, put the pressure on your opponent. That's exactly what Michael did.
Great final in Sydney. Taylor looking to make it 6 out of 6 in Australia in the World Series.
85.
I'm surprised that he stayed there. Couldn't see much of the treble 20 bed after the first two darts. Open target in the 19s would have looked better. However, Michael without a treble on that visit.
There's been too many of those visits for Van Gerwen in this final.
Well, do you know, Taylor could get 9 darts from here. Well, that's a perfect first 3.
May not be enough. We shall see.
Well, Van Gerwen's only going to get 1 dart on the double if Taylor doesn't take this out, which he's not going to now.
100.
Well, it should be the 16s, because 4 16s leave double top. Or is he going for the treble 20? He's going to get 1 dart. Double 16, and double 16 it is. Another crucial checkout from Michael Van Gerwen, and he holds on to his throw.
3 legs on the spin. Wow.
Well, we go back to those 2 missed darts at double 15 for the 90 finish from Phil Taylor.
Which would have made it 6-3 in a double break of throw. Raw emotion on the face of Michael Van Gerwen as he found that finish, 104 finish.
84.
Taylor's got to find something. Because Van Gerwen has picked it up, no doubt. Against the darts, a 4th 180.
Well, he's now getting into that mode of invincibility, isn't he? You know, the way he's walking about, the swagger, a little bit of arrogance, which is confidence. The darts now, if they're missing, they're just above. However, the first dart is not missing. And pressure again on this checkout from Phil Taylor.
It's on. Another one of those. Double 8. Under pressure.
120.
Van Gerwen here with a chance to win 4 straight legs. He needs double 16 to take control of the Sydney final. How important could that prove to be? What a chance for Van Gerwen!
Well, both players are given away important chances, and that's 6 legs apiece. They'll race to 11.
Little fist pump from Taylor as he went back.
140.
Yeah, since the break. Real nail biter. The 9th leg and the 12th leg, all important. Phil Taylor missing 2 darts at double 15 for a 6-3 lead. In the last leg, Michael Van Gerwen missing 2 darts at double 16 for a 4 straight leg and a 7-5 lead.
47.
Who can hold it together?
Well, double stats. Oh, that's a killer blow. double stats, nothing to write home about for the ability of these two.
96.
How important was that dart on the floor? That was a treble 20. All of a sudden, Phil Taylor would have the advantage in this leg. However, he still may get nine darts from here. Oh, that is, he couldn't put it in the treble 20 better. Why on those two darts? This is a 180. Oh, he just overpitched.
40.
That's an important switch, but Phil Taylor here, 141. Remember Van Gerwen. But the treble 8 for 7-5.
Yes, the treble 18 has only given him a dart at the bullseye, though, instead of a dart at the double if he'd hit the treble 20. It's important that Ripley, the treble 20 was a bit covered up. Treble 18. Bullseye for Michael Van Gerwen, and a chance for Phil Taylor now. He's going to get two darts to break the throw.
Terrific final. Living up to expectations.
Oh,
incredible. He can't believe it. Michael Van Gerwen wasn't watching. He had his back turned. Van Gerwen punishes Taylor's missed darts at double this time. Wow. Well, all the missed doubles are adding to the darting drama here in Sydney.
Yes, and they're all at crucial times, Stuart. Isn't it as if someone is having loads of darts at the double when they're so far in front? That's not happening. They are so close on the scoring now.
Terrific adjustment from Taylor after the first dart in the single one. You can feel the tension here inside the event centre at the Star in Sydney.
134.
Believe you me, this means so much to both players. For many, many reasons.
Yeah, I totally agree. It's Michael Van Gerwen stamping his authority on the game. Phil Taylor, this could be the spark that he's looking for, that he needs to get back to winning ways.
177.
Well, another 177. We've seen two from Taylor, one from Van Gerwen here in this
140.
Final.
Phil, you require
140
69.
From Van Gerwen, just to remind Taylor he's tapping his shoulder for an 11 dart leg. Taylor needs double six. Brilliant response from Taylor. Brilliant final here in Sydney. We are going the distance. First to 11 to be crowned the champion in Sydney. And Taylor and Van Gerwen locked at seven legs apiece. Thrilling final between the two form players in World Darts at the moment. Seven apiece, four more legs to be crowned the champion in Sydney. We've seen some dramatic missed doubles, we've seen some brilliant key trebles. The double treble adding to the drama. Seven apiece. Leg nine, Taylor could have gone 6-3 up. Leg 12, Van Gerwen could have gone 7-5 up. Taylor should have broken in the 13th leg, but levelled with an 11 darter in the 14th leg. It's going to come down to nerve now, as much as darting ability.
140.
Taylor knows to win the title for a fourth consecutive year, he's going to have to break the Van Gerwen throw.
Yes, Steve, as you said, I think them two darts at double 15 for 6-3 was massive miss for Phil Taylor. If he's going to go on and win this, Phil, that would have been the crucial time. However, he's still in the game. He can just hold on to his throw. And you go to the last leg, anything can happen in the last leg.
140.
Well, What a big leg this is. Taylor gets his nose in front. Important visit for Michael van Gerwen here. 96. May not be enough.
No, it may not be. If Phil Taylor can hit two trebles with this visit. And, you know, as you can see, Michael van Gerwen has left 165.
He lost concentration, didn't he?
Yeah, Taylor.
94.
The thing that Taylor was thinking there, it looks so sweet for that 120, that 100 for Phil Taylor to leave the 125, which is obviously a better checkout than the 131.
What a chance for Taylor now. Only 57 from van Gerwen. Treble 13, a shot. Double 16 to break the throw.
99.
Well, you feel, Michael, this has to go. What an opportunity here for Taylor. What a chance.
Double 16 it is, and an 8-7 lead for Phil Taylor, and a breaker throw. And you have to say that there was four darts towards the end of that leg that really cost Michael van Gerwen. He left a 165, but didn't help, and then the next three darts, he failed to hit the treble. So Phil Taylor now in a position where if he holds on to his throw, he's going to win the Sydney Masters yet again.
3 180s and 3 177s. And Phil Taylor here means business. Long overdue, a win over Michael van Gerwen. But van Gerwen here has simply failed to fire when it comes to the scoring. I mean, van Gerwen's averaging 101, which is great, but it's not enough. It doesn't look like being enough. Taylor up at 107.
99.
Can van Gerwen find that extra gear, which he so often does when he really needs it?
131.
Well, 419s will leave the third dart at the bullseye. I'm sure this is going to be a treble. Oh, it's a miss. So van Gerwen has already had one dart at the bullseye for a 170 checkout. And he needs it here. There's one. There's two. Bullseye. And again, the third dart is missed. And you can see the anguish on the young Dutchman's face.
That is another key moment in this final. It really is. Taylor's going to have one dart. One dart at tops. Well, we all know how important that is. But just in case we don't, Phil Taylor reminds us. Three legs on the spin for Taylor. Van Gerwen a millimetre or so away from a 170 finish to level it up. Taylor, last dart in hand.
Well, van Gerwen has not been in this sort of situation for quite a while. Normally he's the one that gets out in front. But Taylor's confidence will be growing and growing. The element of doubt will be getting out of his head. He knows to hold the throw means victory.
137.
Taylor taking control of this leg as well on the van Gerwen throw.
Here
from Taylor, or better.
Oh yeah, I mean van Gerwen could have left the 170 there by hitting the 25, but I think the two trebles in the treble 19 made the third one so inviting, so he took the risk. Well, he had 90 early on, he hit the treble 20 and missed the two at double 15, and this would be for another breaker throw for Phil Taylor and put him on the verge of victory. It is two darts at double 15. Oh, he just hit the barrel, it's in.
Four consecutive legs for Taylor. A 12 darter for Taylor. Demolished by Van Gerwen in the World Match Play Final and in the Premier League Final. And now all of a sudden, Phil Taylor is throwing for the title in Sydney once again. The last time Van Gerwen found himself in this sort of situation in a big final, the European Championship Final against Gary Anderson, he was 10-7 down and he won. He won four straight legs. Can he produce something special here in Sydney?
Well, maybe four legs left. Out of those four legs, Michael Van Gerwen's got to find at least two 12s against the throw of Phil Taylor. I don't think he's going to get a chance for 15. I can't see Phil Taylor using more than 15 darts on his throw. Phil Taylor on the verge of a win that he hasn't had for a long time.
Oh, a big win over Michael Van Gerwen, something that he hasn't had for a very long time. Giving himself a chance in this leg, Van Gerwen. But has he left himself too much to do against Taylor? 1-6-4, what a way this would be to win it.
Well, he knows Van Gerwen may only get a dart at the bullseye, so he needs to hit a treble, which he's done. Now Michael needs this treble 17, which is hit. Double 18. Oh, and the switch to the nines is not a good one, and he's missed. Taylor has got a chance to wrap this final up. 1-64, treble 16 gives him two darts at double 8. Couple of 16 gives him the one, the all-important dart. What's it going to be with this first dart?
Taylor has reigned supreme in Australia in the World Series. 24. He's missed one match dart. Van Gerwen to stay alive. And Van Gerwen does stay alive on double 9. Well, Michael Van Gerwen will still believe.
One bullet dodged for Michael Van Gerwen. Still got to break Taylor once more if he's to win this. Will Phil Taylor still be thinking about that double top?
Real tension, that's for sure.
99.
Phil Taylor will give it a real go, that's for sure, in this leg. But he has the cushion of the next leg, but he will have the darts. And I think he may already be looking towards that next leg. Van Gerwen dominating here in the 19th leg of a dramatic final in Sydney.
140.
One match dart for Phil Taylor has come and gone.
No, you kind of feel that Phil Taylor's going to have one chance and it is in the next leg. Hold on to his throw. Double top now for 10-9.
42.
Well, great final. 105 Taylor average, 104, 9-1-80s, 4-1-7-7s. Missed doubles galore to add to all the excitement. Van Gerwen tops to stay alive. And Van Gerwen does. So here is the key leg. It's 10-9. Taylor has already thrown for the title once and had one match dart. These three darts, hugely significant.
Well, Phil Taylor's not been in this position for a little while, Stuart. Can he hold on to his nerve? And that's a great visit. Pressure from the first darts.
Oh,
big advantage to Phil Taylor now.
He beat Van Gerwen 10-3 in Sydney back in 2013. 11-9 in Perth in 2014.
Oh, what a last dart that
How
was
on earth
as well.
Did he manage to find that?
Oh, that's kept him in front.
Oh, and what a time for a maximum from Michael Van Gerwen. Talk about dig deep. Now Van Gerwen has put the pressure on. Taylor may get nine darts from 284. Needs a 140, needs a 137, finds the 137. That's three treble 19s in this last leg already. Oh dear, oh dear. Oh dear, oh dear. Now six darts for Phil Taylor.
Well, those six darts have summed up Michael Van Gerwen's inconsistent final. 180 followed by that last visit. You've just got to hope Taylor can't find a treble, but he can. Taylor's going to get two more match darts. He's going to be under pressure.
I think the face said it all. He doesn't expect Phil Taylor to miss this. What a victory this is for the power. Double 16.
To close out the final. And Phil Taylor wins in Sydney for a fourth straight year. Huge drama. Michael Van Gerwen is beaten by Phil Taylor, and Taylor will milk the moment. Six consecutive World Series wins for Phil Taylor in Australia. Four on the spin for the power in Sydney. Michael Van Gerwen came mighty close to winning in Australia for the very first time, but not close enough. Taylor, a winner in Sydney again. Well, 105 plays 104. The dramatic final with all the missed doubles. Phil Taylor finally gets the job done. Van Gerwen was waiting to force a deciding leg. But Phil Taylor finally, finally winning a big game against Michael Van Gerwen once again. Well, time to celebrate for the Phil Taylor camp, that's for sure. Incredible record that he has here in Sydney. Incredible record that he has in Australia. Michael Van Gerwen, for the third time, losing to Phil Taylor in a final in Australia. Twice now in Sydney and once in Perth.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. A final you thoroughly deserved. What an amazing final. And now it's time for our presentation. Would you please welcome the Chief Executive of the Professional Darts Corporation, Mr. Matthew Porter. And on behalf of Fox Sports, would you please welcome Mr. Lee Terry. Well, ladies and gentlemen, our runner-up receiving his trophy. Would you please, one more time, give it up for Mighty Michael Van Gerwen! And now, ladies and gentlemen, the moment we've all been waiting for, our winner. Receiving the magnificent trophy, but most important of all, undefeated in his fourth successive Sydney title, ladies and gentlemen, to be crowned the Ladbrokes Sydney Darts Masters for a record fourth time, it's the one, the only, Phil the Power!
How good. Once again, Phil Taylor, congratulations. I don't know if you know, but they might be changing the rules. We'll come back here every second week to Sydney and play all the time. You like this joint. You're on fire here.
What's wrong with every week? Why is every second week? This is brilliant. Of course it is. I mean, they got behind us. It was a good final. I thought it was a cracking final. I got Michael there, and then he came back, and he hit the right shot at the right time, and he put me under pressure, I'll be honest. But as Michael said in his interview yesterday, you know, you got a second gear, and I kept thinking, I've got another gear here. I can get him. I just thought he was under pressure.
How do you get it, though, against a guy like this?
Everything's right. My practicing's right. My darts are right. Target have done the right darts for me, so everything's spot on. So I can only improve now.
Absolutely. You've still got improvement left in you.
It made me laugh because the fella down here says, I've got $5 on you. He's down there. I'll give him his $5 back if he wants.
No, he's quite happy with the collect, I think. Yeah. Quite happy with the collect. But this crowd as well, Sydney, I said it at the top there, it's fourth in a row here. I mean, it's outstanding.
I mean, we stayed in a few places in Sydney. This has been my favourite.
You know? Star.
Yeah. It's been fantastic. The star, it's just out the way, it's right on the river, it's beautiful, you know what I mean? And if you want to walk up the town, it's 5 minutes away, this is perfect. For me, perfect.
And Perth, next week as well, you're going to do the Trans-Nullarbor, that's the big desert in between us and where we're standing right now in Perth. Can you do the double?
It's 5 hours on a plane desert, it's a big desert, by the way. Yeah, I'm going to go for it. Simon's picking him up, Jane's picking him up tomorrow afternoon. So I'm really looking forward to it. Listen, I'm on a high now, so I'm going to try and carry it forward.
As you should be as well, mate. Come back to you in a second. I'll just get a quick word with Michael as well. Michael, thank you for sticking around, mate. Well played this week here in Sydney. How did you felt that you performed in that final?
I think I performed well, but I only can blame myself. I made a couple of little mistakes. I had two darts to make it, 7-5 or 8-6, I can't remember. And if you play against Phil in this form, you can't miss against him. And I did, so all the credit to him. He put me under pressure constantly. And yeah, I couldn't do anything more while I did. And also, I tried to come back when I was 10-7 behind. But one bad score, the 47, killed me, really. And he fair play to Phil. He did well. And you know, what can I do more? I just trying to do my best all the time. And yeah. It hurts, but that's the game.
Well, you got him at the match play, so you can't win them all. But you want to win them all.
Of course you can win them all, but you need to play a little bit better.
Yeah, fair enough. What about Perth next week, mate? Looking to get in a bit of a run like you did here. You played very well last night, especially.
Yeah, last night especially. I played fantastic. And I'm playing okay, to be fair. And I had a fantastic break. I went on holiday. And I feel good. You can't win all the time, and that's the thing. Sometimes it hurts, but yeah, what can you do? I just want to make sure I'm going to play okay in Perth, and the preparation starts tomorrow.
It does, straight away. Sydney, quick word on Sydney. How much you've enjoyed the past week before you get over to Perth?
Yeah, it was a fantastic week, to be fair, but you always tried and want to crown the good week with a win, and if you don't win, it's not been a good week, simple, because I can do better than this. And yeah, I only can blame myself, to be fair. It's all the credit to Phil, because he had a fantastic tournament as well. I think this was a good final for the crowd and everyone at home. And yeah, but I can't be happy with the second place.
No, that's the mark of a champion. It's the best final we have seen in Sydney. Well done on your part, mate. We'll see you in Perth next week.
Cheers, thank you.
And a quick last one with Phil. It just came in my head. It's the 52nd main match between you two. You reckon one day you might crack 100 against Michael?
I've got to get away. You said then, sorry.
You've played 52 times now against Michael. It's very close, the head-to-head. Do you reckon one day you might crack the ton, if you like, the 100 meetings between yourself and Michael?
No, I don't think so. Not now. But I'm going to give him... I'm pleased I'm playing like I can, obviously. And I'm pleased I can give Michael a game. I mean, he's been storming it every week, so he's up for a challenge now. And he doesn't like it, obviously, you know. But this is what you've got to do. I said, he beat me in Blackpool, but you've got to beat Michael. You've got to play like Michael plays. You've got to be aggressive. You've got to believe you can beat him. Of course you have. And you've got to go out there and show him. So he's in for a battle now. He won't be happy, but I'll be after him. Trust me. I think Adrian Lewis, I think Chizzy, I think all of them. Peter Rapp was gutted tonight, trust me. because he didn't play like he can. But there's a lot of players now after Michael because he's setting the bar now.
Well, it puts the bar up higher and higher in the sport. Phil, well done on your part tonight. Congratulations once more. Enjoy the victory.
Thank you.
Phil, the power tailor, everyone.